how to set up crossover filters on a matrix, how to send the main left-right to a matrix, and how to route a matrix with physical output so you can actually connect it to a loudspeaker.
First thing you need to do is link the matrices, because the main mix is a stereo signal. It's a left and right. So I'm gonna go ahead and select the first matrix, go to the home page, and click on link. Confirm, and this now is a stereo pair. I'm gonna do the same thing for the rest, so select the third one, click, link, confirm. The third and fourth are now a pair. Then select the fifth one and link, confirm. And these are three stereo pairs. This is for the low frequencies, this is for the mid frequencies, and this is for the high frequencies. I'm gonna select the first pair, go over to the EQ, turn it on, and go to the high frequencies. Make sure it's a high cut, and go over here to the EQ, and lower the frequency till around 100 hertz. It all depends on the speakers you're using. I'm just picking a random number for the sake of this example. Okay, cool. I'm gonna select now the second pair and also turn on the EQ and select the low frequencies and make sure it's a low cut and go up to 100 hertz, the same as the other one. So this first pair is starting from 20 hertz up to 100 hertz. This is starting from 100 hertz. I'm gonna also need to cut the highs because the second pair is just for the mid frequencies. So I'm gonna select the high and make sure it's a high cut and go ahead and lower the frequency till it's about 4K. Okay, and now I'm gonna go to the third pair, select it, turn on the EQ and go to the low and make sure it's a low cut. And I'm gonna go up with the frequency till it's about the same as the other one. So 4K. This is 4K. Okay, so now this is for the bass, 20 to 100 hertz. This is for the mids, so 100 to 4K. This is for the highs, 4K all the way up to 20,000 hertz.
And if you're using a two-way system, it's just one less step. So just cut the highs on one pair and cut the lows on one pair at the same frequency, and that's it. Now that all the crossover points are set, you still need to send the main left-right to all three stereo pairs of matrices.
So you're gonna select the main left-right and then click flip fader and send the first pair, send it to the second pair, and send it to the third pair. And make sure to turn this off again, okay? This is very important. And if you wanna make sure that all three pairs are exactly at zero, you can click on here, view, in the bus sends section, click view, and right here you can view the levels. So we have the main left right selected. The first pair is -1.8, I will make it zero. The second pair is -1.5, I will make it zero. And the third pair is exactly zero. Okay, this is how you make sure you're sending an equal amount of level to all the matrices.
Okay, cool, but you still need to route the matrices to a physical output to be able to connect it to a speaker, right? So here's how to do it.
Go to the routing page, and then go to the right, to the out page. And now I'm gonna say that output one is gonna go to matrix one, output two is gonna go to matrix 2, output 3, to matrix 3, 4, to matrix 4, output 5, to matrix 5, output 6, to matrix 6. Cool. And now these are the XLR outputs on the back of the console. And if you're using the mono center bus, you can also do that. Go to output 7 and go to the main LRC and select it as the main mono slash center, and that will be the mono bus for the bass channels if you're using extra subs.
If this was helpful, consider hitting the like button, I would appreciate that very much. And if you're using different speakers on different distances, you might wanna learn how to delay them or time align them. So click on this video right here to learn how to do output delays and or channel delays to align microphones. Click right here. I'm waiting.